Kirsty here is struggling to sort pivot table slices in line with her fiscal periods, which run from July to June. Why don't you take a break, Kirsty? Let me sort it out. Really? Thank you so much. You're a lifesaver. Okay, I can see here Kirsty has a pivot table with the dates grouped by month and year, which I can confirm are derived by grouping the date field. And if we look at the field list, we can see the additional fields for month and year have been added as a result of the groups. If I right-click the slicer, you can see my only sort options are ascending or descending order. So one option is to create a custom list to sort the months based on Kirsty's fiscal period. I'll do that over here out of the way and just enter the first month, July, and then left-click and drag to fill it down. Then on the File tab, under Options, Advanced, scroll right to the bottom and Edit Custom Lists. I can type the list in, but it's quicker to select the cells containing the list I just created and then import. To get the slicer to pick up the new custom list, simply refresh the pivot table. And if you have any problems here, check that the slicer settings have Use Custom Lists when sorting checked. Kirsty, are you planning on adding data for future periods to this report? Because if you are, you probably should use a different approach.
Yeah, this report will show a rolling 2-year view of sales.
Probably should have asked that before starting. An easy option is to simply add a slicer for the year field, but this is a bit clunky because not only do two slicers take up more space, but you have to filter the year and month fields separately, so it's more work. Let's delete the year slicer. A sneaky workaround is to add a column to your data set that duplicates the date field. I'll call it period. And I can simply copy the date across with the keyboard shortcut Control R. I'll Control 1 to format the dates in the period column year month. This way the field will sort numerically in the slicer. And let's refresh the pivot table to pick up the new field. Now I can insert a slicer for the period field. And just note that I'm not using this field in the pivot table itself. It's simply there for the slicer. And because the dates are formatted year month, they automatically sort in ascending order. I'll format the slicer with two columns so we can see more dates without scrolling. Now this works fine, but if you're working with a lot of data, this extra column is not the most efficient solution.
Oh, by the way, the boss wants me to create a chart for sales by segment in the order I've got them listed on the segment sheet. Apparently, this report has been sent out to all the segment managers and they are particular about the order.
Okay, well, we could manually left-click and drag the segments in the pivot table to sort them, but the slicer will still be sorted alphabetically. We could set up another custom list for the slicer, but custom lists don't travel with the Excel file, which means you'd have to install the custom list on each user's PC. So I think the best option is to use the data model, and it's also more efficient at storing large amounts of data. I'll delete this chart and pivot table. And using the data without the sneaky workaround that I added in the previous example, I'll insert a new pivot table, and this time check the box, add this data to the data model, which is just another name for Power Pivot. Let's quickly build the pivot table with the segment in the row labels and sales in the values area. Now, to custom sort the segments, I'll add the segment table here with the sort order column to the data model. You can see in the table tab, it's already formatted in a table and it's called segments. So via the Power Pivot tab, add to data model. Another way you can load data to the data model is via Power Query, but this will do for now. Here we are in the Power Pivot window, and I can set the sort order for the segment field via the Home tab, Sort By. And in the dialog box here, I want to sort the segment column by the segment sort order. Next in Power Pivot, I need to create a relationship between the data and segment tables. I like to do this in the diagram view because you simply left click and drag the segment field in the segment table to the segment field in the data table. You should have the many side, as denoted by the asterisk, on the data table side of the connector and the arrow pointing towards the data table. I'll hide the segment field in the data table from client tools. This is going to prevent Kirsty and I from accidentally using the unsorted field in pivot tables and charts. Now, while I'm in the data model, I'll set the number format for the sales column to comma separated and no decimal places. This way, It'll automatically be formatted whenever Kirsty uses it in any other pivot tables or charts. I can go back to Excel now and switch out the unsorted segment field for the sorted one. And I'll insert a slicer for the segment field from the segment table. Now that we have the data in the data model, it makes sense to rebuild the first pivot table for sales by month. And just like regular pivot tables, Power Pivot pivot tables also group dates by year and month. And the same problem exists where we need to use separate slices for year and month. To get around this, we can automatically create a calendar table. We do that via the Design tab, Date Table. Now, Power Pivot analyzes the smallest and largest dates in your data set and creates a calendar table containing a date for every day. Notice it automatically contains a column with month and year combined. However, if you use this in a pivot table, it's going to sort alphabetically, which is useless. You could add a numeric column and use sort by to sort this field, but an easier way is to add a column that concatenates the year and month fields. And then it's going to automatically sort in the correct order. So I'll select the year column and concatenate a hyphen. And then because the month number field contains some single digit numbers, I'll use the format function and format the month number into two digits. Press enter. And now I have a single column containing the year and month that I can use in my slicer. Let's rename it year month. Now, before I move on, I should point out that you can update your calendar table to include new dates as your data grows. Just do that via the date table dropdown. Did you get that, Kirsty? It's all right for some. Let's go to the diagram view and connect the calendar table to the data table. Remember, make sure you drag the date field in the calendar table to the date field in the data table. To avoid using the date field from the data table in your pivot tables, right-click on it and click on Hide from Client Tools. Okay, let's go back to Excel and we'll build the pivot table. So on the Insert tab, we want Pivot Table and we want From Data Model. I'll put it on the existing segments worksheet. You can see here in the field list, I have three tables. Where available, the row and column labels should always come from your dimension tables. And I'll put the date hierarchy in my row labels and sales from the data table in the values area. Let's expand the date hierarchy to show the months. And then my slicer will be from the calendar table, year month field. If you prefer to have a slicer that just contains the month name sorted in line with your fiscal year, you can add another table to the data model containing the month names and a numeric column to set the sort by, like I did for the segments. That can be your homework, Kirsty.
What now?
Someone might have to watch this video. Now, it might seem like a lot to set up, but it's worth it if you're working with large data sets or if you need to share the file with others, because unlike custom lists, the sort settings travel with the file. Not to mention the additional capabilities Power Pivot offers over regular pivot tables, including far more flexibility and capacity to work with large data sets spread across multiple tables. And the bonus of learning Power Pivot is it's available in both Excel and Power BI, so the skills are transferable. Check out my Power Pivot and DAX course linked to in the video description below. And now that you've got your slices sorting the way you want, it's time to learn some formatting hacks to make them small so they don't take up so much space. So check out this video next. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.